We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hello, 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 America, and welcome to another episode of Hot Chicks Live on LA Talk Live. I am your host, Rhonda Ray, and thank you everybody who's taken the time to tune in on this Thursday afternoon. I know that you have many choices to do with your hour, but thank you for being here with us. I promise you we're going to have a great show. Again, you can find me here every Thursday, 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Hot Chicks Live, where we talk about our topics of discussion include fashion, entertainment, music, sports, lifestyle, and more. Basically, just everything Rhonda Ray. It's my platform. I do what I want to do. So, hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving. We were off last week for Thanksgiving, but I hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving, and I'm excited about the show today. So, for those of you who are just tuning in, or it's your first time tuning in, the show is called Hot Chicks Live, and what that means is that for those of you that are not familiar with the show, Hot Chicks Live is a women's empowerment-based show, and what we do here is we celebrate, we inspire, uplift other women, and their achievements that are doing their thing all around town, in the community, and in the world. So this base of the show is women's empowerment, and we want to encompass other women and just, like I said, celebrate their achievements. So we have two dynamic women in the house today, in studio today, as my guests, and we'll get to them after the break. But we just want to... let me see, I got my cue cards here. So this is a live broadcast, and if you miss the broadcast, we will be streaming on Ustream right after the show, so no worries there. So hello to all of our listeners, viewers. You can tune in, you can call in, you can stream live. Call in and be a part of the show, be a friend to the show. Like I said, we've got two dynamic women in the house today. We have Amber Cobra Hobson, owner of Hair Escapades, and we have Big Chan from House of Cinderella. Is that right? Did I say that right? Yeah, House of Cinderella. So we'll be coming back with them after the break, but we just wanted to, again, thank you for tuning in to LA Talk Live. We broadcast in several different cities and states. Los Angeles, New York. Where else do we have back here? New Jersey, Houston, St. Louis, Boston, Washington. So if you know anybody in those areas, invite them on in to kind of chime in with us and pick our brains. We love callers and, you know, people to call in and just kind of pick our brains. So welcome to Hot Chicks Live. So without further ado, we're going to go to a small break. And when we come back, as I discussed, we will have some dynamic women in the house with us. So just stay tuned there. I promise you it's going to be a great and a fun show. Keep it locked right there. You're listening and watching Hot Chicks Live on LATalkLive.com.
Check it out now. Check it out now. No doubt, yo. You such a thing, a sexy little thing. I'm hot pointing, admiring your chain. You got a fella nose wide on the realer side. I wanna dance real close, right up on your high. Playing games, yo, I never cared about it much. Yo, you the girl who keep her eyes closed for smoking dust. For real, you such a little pretty belle. You make a nigga front pants hit a mean swell.
What you say?
I said you stimulate my brain cell. Yo, there's one thing I really wanna say.
Well,
you're such a vibrant, 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 a vibrant, vibrant.
We know there are many choices of internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
If your doctor has prescribed more heat, SoCalGas has some heartwarming news for you. The Medical Baseline Allowance Program can help offset costs by providing additional natural gas at the lowest SoCalGas rate. To apply, visit SoCalGas.com/medical or call 1-800-427-2200. 1-800-427-2200. Legs move it side to side, smack it in the air. Shoulders sideways, smack it in the air. Smack it in the air. Legs move it side to side, smack it in the air.
And we're back. We're back on Hot Chicks Live. And as I promised, we have Amber Cobra Hobson in the house with us today. Come up to the mic.
Hey, good evening, everyone.
Good evening. We're still waiting for our other guests, but for right now, we're going to keep it on moving. So like I said, this platform encompasses women and their achievements and doing their thing. So Amber, thank you for being here with us today.
Thank you for having me. I'm really honored.
Yeah, thank you for being here. And Amber came in bringing gifts, so I can't wait to see what's inside of my goodie bag. You have so much going on. We have so much territory to cover. But first and foremost, like I said, we wanted to start by, you know, talking about your journey.
Yes.
A lot of people don't know. They may just know you as a hairstylist,
right?
But a lot of people don't know your actual journey and where you came from,
mm-hmm.
And that you were in a rap group back
yes.
in the day, and you made a transition into being a business owner. So give us a little insight on where you started, where you came from and where you
right.
are now.
Right. Well, as you know, how I met you as
right.
Cobra.
Correct.
Cobra Red. I was in a rap group called the Five Footers,
mm-hmm.
and we were signed to Warren G, you know, G-Funk Family. I'm
right.
part of that whole era, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So it was a really wonderful experience. I learned a lot. Shouts out to Warren G
mm-hmm.
for putting us on and giving us the opportunity to be heard, to make money off of our lyrics.
Wow.
And
okay.
you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And just giving us that platform to express ourselves and be, you know, be who we are. But how I transitioned was our album happened to be on hiatus.
Okay.
And because I was a single mother,
right.
you know how that goes,
yeah,
the
no,
hustle
we...
continues.
Oh my goodness, yes.
And it was one of those things where I had to survive, me and my son.
Absolutely.
So when everything was kind of put on hold, it's like, what do?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I had little and odd jobs here and there.
Mm-hmm.
And then what happened was I always knew how to braid. I ended up working at a hair salon where I met Rhonda. I actually met Rhonda at Platinum Cuts. It was
mm-hmm.
a salon in Studio City.
Yes.
And those
memories
were the good
there,
old days.
Right?
Yes.
Yes,
good
my
old
goodness,
days.
Yes.
And just working there,
mm-hmm.
see, because, you know, my album was on hiatus,
mm-hmm.
you know, I didn't have a license or anything. I was
right.
just a braider. So I
right.
was like, everybody would be like, you know, are you going to go to school? And I was
mm-hmm.
like, man, my album about to come out.
Yeah.
Girl, please.
Yeah. That, right.
I took my behind to school.
Right.
And I just kind of thugged it out, you
right,
know.
Right.
I did the school thing, and in the process, once I got my license, me and Lolita Goods, who's my mentor, my hair mentor,
mm-hmm.
Me and her started a company. It was called Hair. That's how Hair Escapades
right.
started. Because Amber's Escapades was just me doing, you know, I'm always traveling and just always got an escapade going on.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So
yeah.
I used to sell jewelry and stuff online
oh,
and
just
clothes.
A straight hustler, right?
Yeah.
yeah. Single parent hustle. Right.
right. So that was Amber's escapades.
Okay.
And when I got with Lolita, we were trying to think of we had like a workshop doing hair extension workshops all throughout California,
mm-hmm.
Southern California,
mm-hmm.
just teaching cosmetology students and veterans how to do these extension techniques.
Right.
So that's how I kind of was able to transition, do that. And then eventually, you know, working at salons and
mm-hmm.
after a while.
So let's back up a little bit and back into the rap group. Now, were you sought out by Warren G or how did you actually become a member of the group?
Wow, that's an interesting question. Well, no, what happened was Josh Skills, who's one of the original, at first it was Josh Skills and Neb Love. Now, mm-hmm. Neb Love was my best friend.
Okay.
So she was already, she the one that got discovered by Warren.
Okay.
And, you know, she didn't want to do a project by herself. So Neb Love, which was my best friend, hopped in, and mm-hmm. that's what was the signed group at first.
Mm-hmm.
But then they had the crew, which was called Unit 5. That was me, Knee-High, K-Bar, and Knee-High and K-Bar. Right.
So how many members of the Five-Footers were there?
There were five, but then we also had Pinky. Pinky was the sixth member, even though she wasn't signed with us, but she still did, you know, projects with us.
So did the Five-Footers mean that you were all under 5 feet, or
yeah.
just because you had five members?
No, okay. Because it was actually because we were little. We okay. were all little and crazy.
Right.
So you can imagine
right.
that type of situation.
And you guys hail from Compton, right?
I'm from Compton.
Okay.
I'm the only one from Compton, and you have Knee-High from L.A., you have K-Bar from Carson,
got
you have
it.
Josh Skills mm-hmm. from L.A., and mm-hmm. so on and so on, but we're, mm-hmm. we're all from Cali.
Right. Right. Okay. Okay. And so you were saying that Neb Love?
They did the first deal, but then they brought us along to do a song called The Heist,
okay.
which was on the Set It Off soundtrack.
Wow. Okay. So that was a good push, right?
Yeah. So mm-hmm. that's how I was able to kind of get in and be able to tour and mm-hmm. and you know got my feet wet. And then after a while, when that deal went sour with Def Jam, then we end up signing another deal where it was all five of us.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then that's where, you know.
Okay. And so who did you guys tour with back then?
Oh my goodness, the list goes on. Girl, Donnell Jones.
Oh wow.
You know, Dog Pound.
Yeah.
You know, Nate Dogg, of uh-huh. course.
Of course.
He was in the of second course. Tour bus.
Excuse me, let's get our Chan Uh-oh. Right on in here. Uh-oh. Come right on in and take a seat.
Biscuit.
Come right on in. I know this LA traffic ain't no joke, right?
They tried me.
They tried you, Chan. They tried me. Get your earphones on then. I know you got your pom-pom up there.
Okay.
Can you hear us?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Oh, well, unwind. Make yourself at home. Why don't you put your stuff in the chair over there so it's off camera. And
yeah, we're on camera, honey.
Yeah, we all know
Smile
each other.
Camera.
So I was just talking to Amber about her experience in the Five Footers. So that's right. where we started at. And then we'll jump to you because we know that you came from a rap group as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, so you were just saying that you guys were touring with Donnell Jones.
It was just all different types of people who we opened up for. Yo-Yo mm-hmm. was a huge supporter. She would have mm-hmm. us open up for her, mm-hmm. you know, like at the Forum and just other events. Girl, the list goes on. Yeah,
right,
then we
right.
was on the show, that movie, The Show, where
okay.
it was Method Man and Biggie and all. It was like a whole tour thing with Def Jam.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot.
It was like, so
yeah.
you guys were actually signed to a couple labels.
Well, actually, I was signed to mm-hmm. one label with them.
Okay,
Josh Skills and Neighbors. They had two different deals.
Okay,
right.
Okay, okay. Mm-hmm. So we're just gonna jump right in, Chan, because we talk.
I'm still trying to catch my breath. But I was here.
You's here. Well,
here.
Put your microphone up a little bit.
Okay.
And what you guys mirror is that you both were in rap groups back in the day.
Female
rap groups. So what we were saying before you walked in is that, you know, we were talking about her transition from the rap group to business owner where she is now. Mm-hmm. You have that same Cinderella, pun
yes,
intended,
pun
story
intended.
story as well. So why don't you tell us about the rap group you were in and how you kind of made the transition and what your journey was.
Well, actually, I was in two rap
groups. Oh, okay.
I was first signed by Eazy-E.
Okay.
He handpicked me, and I was in a group called GBM.
Okay.
We don't need to say what that means,
okay.
but, you know, we were going to be an extension of N.W.A., but we were going to be a female version.
Okay.
Long story short,
mm-hmm.
Bone hopped on that Greyhound bus with that one-way ticket. You know.
Okay.
That blew all our chances. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, when Eazy discovered them, they had something unique. And
uh-huh.
he was just on the verge of breaking up with N.W.A. So
okay.
that was his get back.
Okay.
Not to say we wasn't dope, but
right.
as we all know, it's in the history
books. Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
by the time we were getting ready to get around to our project, because he wanted to piggyback us off of them,
mm-hmm.
unfortunately, he got mm-hmm. sick and he passed.
Right, yeah. right.
So
yeah.
I had another record deal.
Okay. Okay, let's just move back. So that the name of that group was called what? Doggies Angels?
No,
no, G-J. That was
Was with Ruthless Records.
Oh, that was with Ruthless, mm-hmm. Right? Okay,
and we were called GBM.
GBM, you
which
did
stood
say that.
For Gangsta Bitch Mentality.
Oh, okay.
Ow, ow. So you know, moving forward, I had a demo deal, and okay. I got signed with Sony, and I was working with this guy named Tim Dog. Mm-hmm. He actually heard my homegirl play. Mm-hmm. The demo that I recorded, and okay. He was like, who's that? So he came to the house. Long story short, I was in New York. I was working. He was giving me placements.
Right.
And that deal didn't fall through because at the time they had another artist, and I won't say her name, but mm-hmm. she was with a crew that was popping. So mm-hmm. they was like, instead of going there, we're going to go here.
Okay.
Great. Mm-hmm. I still had that demo, though.
Okay. All right. You're still working that demo.
I still was working that demo, though. Thanks for the little coins.
Right.
I could pay my producer, and exactly. I could pay for my little tracks, and now right. I got me a demo.
I got me a demo, mm-hmm. right.
Mm-hmm. I never forget, I went to the club that Prince owned downtown.
Glam Flam. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Snoop was there. He was in a dice game. They were on the balcony.
Okay.
So I walked over there, and I was like, Snoop. I just busted up the dice game. I was
okay.
like,
because you ain't never been scared.
Never been scared. I was like, I got a demo. I want you to listen to it. And if you don't like it, don't throw it out the window. Mm-hmm. Just run it back, you know? Mm-hmm. Long story short, that's how Doggies Angels was kind of mm-hmm. born, because he followed up, gave me a call one day, and
the
rest is kind of history.
Yeah. So you were signed to Snoop's label?
Yes.
Okay.
Doghouse Records.
Doghouse Records. And were you guys the first act on Doghouse Records?
I'm trying to think if the Eastsiders came out before us. I think the Eastsiders came out first, and then we came out.
Okay. So we're talking probably like mid-90s for both of you guys, or early 90s? Early yeah. 90s,
we were
right?
on the verge of like 99, 2000, because
oh, okay.
we came out in 2000.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Gotcha, gotcha. So did you guys do any touring? Or?
Oh, my God. We did a lot to be in that little time.
In that window.
We
right.
went on tour. We went on the Puff Puff Pass tour. I okay. mean, we were on Rap City, The Basement. Mm-hmm. Just when Jenny Jones, Ricky Lake, and all those people
oh,
were
okay.
popping, we were uh-huh. on Soul Train. We were Soul
Beautiful.
Train presenting. Dinners. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was a dream come true. We did
right.
a lot in such a little time. And,
right.
you know, we had three singles out. Two of them was ours, and then we had one with Badass.
Okay.
Which
okay.
was another label mate.
Okay. So, yeah, that's kind of how your journey. Now, how did you transition into, because you've transitioned not to where you are now, but there's been a couple of other steps along the way. So why don't you fill us in on.
Oh, my God. Well, first of all, I used to do hair.
Okay, so when we all have that in common, because when I moved here from the Bay Area, so all of our hustles are quite the same.
Exactly, because my mom, she did hair for 20 years on
right.
Crenshaw.
Okay.
Everybody knew who she was,
okay.
and when she didn't have a babysitter, of course I was younger
right
then,
mm-hmm.
but she would take us to work with her, or mm-hmm. I would go to school with her, and I'd be in the back real gangster with it, braiding,
right.
making
okay.
my coins,
okay.
you know? So I kind of kept that, and that was my hustle.
Uh-huh.
And I just kind of like hustled it into the industry, because Dion Perignon at the time
right.
saw my work, and then I signed to her agency.
Absolutely.
So
shout out to Dion.
And then me and Monica connected, and
Monica
we became
the singer
friends. Yes,
okay.
Miss just one of those
Miss
days.
Thang.
Yeah,
Miss Thang, Miss Thang.
And you know, I started working with her a lot. So from that point on, everything just kind of like progressed, and
right.
I was just, you know, I was doing big things back then.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Then again, I would always run into Snoop, because Master P was popping at the time. He was signed to No Limit.
Wow, that's interesting. I'm going to stop you there okay. because I work on The Real, and he was on the show today. So I'm a stylist on The Real, so we all have some kind of creativity in common, where we've all done hair, and you guys have been in rap groups, and now we both are in the costuming styling industry. So, yeah, shout out to Master P. I lint rolled him today. Make sure he didn't have no logos
right,
on.
Right, right. And it's funny you should say that, because I used to do Tia and Tamara's hair. They
oh,
were my clients as
wow,
well.
Wow,
yes.
wow,
so fast forward, when Snoop was signed to No Limit, I remember working with this other producer, and we was working out the garage. We was doing it real gutter back then.
Yeah, yeah.
And
they call it gorilla style. Right?
It was gorilla style. And I remember him saying, you know, I guess he felt kind of betrayed, because he was like, so you did a deal with Snoop?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, what are you
now,
talking about?
Now, who are we talking about?
It was a producer named Overdose.
Okay. And that was with the Eazy-E camp?
No. This was just me still working. Oh, okay. And just, you know, okay. Whoever got tracks, we in there.
We in there, right.
We in there.
Putting out content.
Right. Yeah. And so he was like, you did a deal with someone. I was like, what you talking about? He was like, well, I looked on the back of his album and he said that you and Goldie was his new artist coming up. And I was like, for real? What? So, you know, I kind of just let it marinate for a minute.
Right.
But the next day came, I went to the record store, I bought that album, and I saw that on the back. I was like, ow!
Like, I'm about to blow up.
This is about to go damn, Snoop Dogg.
Okay. Right. At his prime, right? Yeah.
Well, that's when he left Death Row, and he was building his own label when he was with No Limit.
Correct. Right. Yeah. Make him say, with the big tanks and everything. Right. So, Amber, going back to you were just saying that there was a couple of different you know, steps to your journey and leading up to where you are now.
My defining moment with the music industry was when we were signed to Restless Records. And how it was set up was that Warren G is a production company.
Correct.
So it's an umbrella underneath the big company, which is Restless.
Absolutely.
Who's, you know, giving us the money.
Yes.
Well, you know, apparently from when our album was done, we were supposed to get some more money, right? Mm-hmm. And I went to the head of Restless, you know, white guy, you know, I'm sitting right in this, you know,
boss
right here
lady
desk,
stuff, right?
And I'm like,
then.
Hey, yeah. I got a son, I need some money, like,
right,
what's up? We
right.
finished the album, what's cracking? And he looked at me and went like this, we don't have no money for you. Ooh. And I had to go get on the county, and I was signed to a record label.
Wow.
So
that was like
my
a Pink
brain,
story, right?
Girl, yeah. I don't know who's. I know that right? was my story. I don't know nothing about Pink, but
mine is similar to your story.
So that's when I had to be like, okay, you know what? I have to put destiny into my own hands. And
right.
the only way this is going to work as far as me surviving and getting ahead and succeeding is that I take control
right.
of my life. I can't depend on anybody but myself.
Right.
And that's when I started reaching out, trying to figure it out. Like, okay, what's the next hustle? What's the
right.
next, you know what
right.
I mean?
So that's where we left off before Chan walked in. You were saying that you and your mentor started traveling and doing
hair extension
care.
Workshops. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's where the name Hair Escapade started.
Okay.
From that point, because mm-hmm. we were trying to think of a name for our workshops. Mm-hmm. And she was like, man, well, escapades, I know you got Amber's Escapades, but that'll be dope if we throw hair on it.
Right.
Because we're traveling, we're, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? That's what escapades is all about.
That
like
is
every,
escapade,
you know what I mean?
Right.
So
yeah.
we incorporated that, and we didn't know anything about it. This was our first time even doing it. We just kind of did it. You
right.
know what I mean? Just
right.
as we went, just figured it out. You
right,
know?
Right, right. So that platform then led you to being a business owner, correct?
Right,
okay.
right, right. Well, that was my first partnership
right.
type deal. I always used to do little stuff here and there, mm-hmm. selling stuff, but mm-hmm. that's when I really kind of took it real serious mm-hmm. then. And then from that point, you know, I worked at salons and, you know, after school, I just kind of like, you know, worked at salons and getting kicked out of salons. Because I just, it's one of those things where when
right.
you know what you want to do, you know how business is supposed to be. And
correct.
You start colliding with people who not about their business.
Right.
And who don't take it
right.
seriously.
Absolutely.
Who don't see your vision.
Mm-hmm.
And then after a while, I stepped away, got a little suite,
mm-hmm.
studio suite.
Mm-hmm.
And then from that point on.
And the suite is quite nice. I've been there.
Well,
yeah,
no, I'm not.
A,
they don't have a, I have a storefront now.
Yeah, and we're going to talk about that in a second now.
Excuse me.
But the suite was, it was
It
cool.
was real
it
cute.
Was.
Very,
was
very
but then,
cute.
You know, mm-hmm. you. It's a whole story.
That's a whole nother story,
yeah,
right?
Because, well, you know what? God has a funny way of sometimes kicking you in the butt.
Absolutely.
And just
kicking
being
you
like,
out.
Yeah,
yeah.
Like, you know what? No, this, I got something else planned for you.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't even, in my brain, this year was not the plan to do the salon.
Mm-hmm.
The plan was to really, just really get this hair product thing
mm-hmm.
going. But
mm-hmm.
how things worked out, it was time for me to move on from
yeah.
there, you know?
Yeah.
So
great. And we're going to talk about that more in the second hour. But so, Chan, you, Big Chan, you transitioning out of the music. There was a couple other steps that were in between there. So what did you do after you did hair?
That's when I got the record deal with Snoop and the group was born.
Okay, so the hair was first,
the
and then the
was
group
first,
was second.
And then the group.
Uh-huh.
And while being in the group, we're only one album deep in the game.
Okay.
We got a pretty big
yeah.
buzz.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we went gold on our first round.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
it
not too many
and
people
that,
can
yeah, that was
do
good.
That,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
So one of the members in our group decided she wanted to go solo. And
that
so
always happens,
yeah,
right?
And I'm like, okay, let us get our feet wet first. Yeah. We all came to the table solo,
right?
But let's like get more notoriety.
Correct.
And then go solo. At
Absolutely.
Least you'll have a fan base.
Yeah, sink right. your feet
exactly.
in first. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, long story short, she ended up leaving,
mm-hmm.
and so it was just two of us, mm-hmm. and it just started to become a little bit unbelievable at that point, yeah. because mm-hmm. people were used to seeing three girls.
Okay.
So it was a random thing. Like, I could be with any two girls and they'll just be like, oh, Doggy's Angels, you know?
Right.
So I could tell that, you know, it just wasn't going to work.
Right.
Long story short.
Mm-hmm.
We tried to redo the deal with Snoop. He kept saying he wanted to do it and XYZ. Long story short, the group broke up,
mm-hmm.
and we asked to get out of our contracts, mm-hmm. because Snoop was the priority,
right.
at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
And every time his project came around, nothing else really mattered because it couldn't. It was a conflict of interest. We never had a manager. This is the guy who signed us. He calls the shots. He
right.
say yay. He say no. So when it's time for him to do his thing, and we like, we got a little momentum going here,
mm-hmm.
like we need to keep working.
Mm-hmm.
But that wasn't the case.
Mm-hmm.
So we got out of our contract, and I remember calling up to TVT because that was our distributor at the time.
Okay.
I'm on the phone like, yo, can we get this project going? Like,
right.
open up the budget. We need coins. We need
Absolutely.
This. We need that. You know, the other girl
Same
had
thing,
a baby.
Right?
You know what I'm saying? And I'm like the breadwinner for my family.
Right.
And it was
right.
just a lot at that time.
Mm-hmm.
So wasn't no money coming in.
Right.
I became homeless.
Wow.
I was sleeping in a car.
Mm.
I was from pillow to post.
Mm.
And, you know, good friend of mine was like, come to Atlanta. I remember driving to Atlanta with $100 in my pocket.
Yeah, and that story we're going to get to after the break, because that is
okay.
a good story.
Okay,
and
I can't wait to hear that
yeah.
one.
Yeah.
Shut up.
That's a great story.
Tried and tested.
Yeah, tried and tested. So we're going to go to a break, and we'll be right back with more of Hot Chicks Live on LA Talk Live.
You used to. Yeah. You used to call me on my cell phone. Late night when you need my love. Call me on my cell phone. Late night when you need my love. And I know when that hotline bling, that can only mean one thing. I know when that hotline bling, can only mean one thing. Ever since I left the city, you got a reputation for yourself now. Everybody knows and I feel left out. Girl, you got me down, you got me stressed out. Ever since I left the city, you.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and hosts of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Women now make up 37% of the workforce, changing their role forever.
Harvard Medical School has now opened its doors to new female applicants.
The first woman is now in space.
The majority of last year's doctorate degrees were earned by women.
We've come so far, but our news is changing for the worse. More women die from heart disease and stroke than men, even though it can be prevented. Make a change at GoRedForWomen.org today. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the American Heart Association's Go Red for Women.
Welcome to Artistic Direction with me, Alison Edwards, the transportee from across the sea. I want to invite you to my live show on Thursdays at 1 p.m. talking about everything artistic, inventive and creative. What will be a fun-filled hour including music, film and television news with live makeovers, phone-ins, giveaways and competitions to get your creative minds going. And I get to hang out with some fantastic guests. So, don't forget to tune in to Artistic Direction with me, Alison Edwards, on Thursdays at 1 p.m. exclusively on latalklive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B, Live 365, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, AHA Radio, TiVo Radio, and Apple TV Radio. Or just watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Yeah.
Hot Chicks Live. And in studio with me today is Big Chan of House of Cinderella. You're like, meow.
I just can't help it.
And Ambra Cobra Hobson.
Holla.
CEO of Hair Escapades. I have business women at the table with me today. So when we left off, Chan was giving us her journey, telling us her story about her journey, how she transitioned from rap group, from doing hair to rap group to being homeless and to where you are now. So we're just going to kind of delve back into that. And so you were saying that after a while
you became homeless.
Okay.
And I remember this guy duped me because I was with this makeup artist, and she had a car that this guy was going to the auctions and getting. I had saved up. I had like $1,000. And so I was like, you know, I gave the man my money to bring me a car.
Oh, my goodness.
Honey, he brung me this raggedy Thunderbird.
And you was rolling it.
Yes, she was. She was going to gigs. She was getting her coins. Right. She was stacking her chips.
That's right.
But before that, I had went to Atlanta. And mm-hmm. like I said, I had $100 in my pocket.
Okay.
And, you know, my buddy said, come on down. So mm-hmm. in Atlanta, you know, they have attics and they have mm-hmm. basements. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, there's a home in the middle.
Right.
So I was like, can I stay in the attic? Because
right.
I didn't want to see nobody.
Right.
I just wanted to get in touch with me and figure out where was I going from here.
That was between you and God, right?
It was between me and God.
Yeah.
And I knew he was doing something because mm-hmm. I had paid my dues as far as rapping
mm-hmm.
for some years before I had got to that point. So I'm like, how does it happen that I get a breakthrough and then I'm here,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
So, you know, there was a sewing machine in the attic. Now, my mom had bought me a sewing machine when I was younger. It didn't work, but it sat in the house,
mm-hmm.
and I guess it was the start of all things
mm-hmm.
because her aunts used to sew, and I remember I probably was like 6 or 7,
mm-hmm.
and she used to take me with her when she went to her cousin's house, and I remember sewing machines, I remember fabrics, and I was intrigued by that,
mm-hmm.
and it just stuck with me because mm-hmm. I was always a fashionable person.
Right, right.
So living in that attic, I got the sewing machine, and I told, you know, my people's like, let's go to Walmart
because right.
I need to get a few things,
yeah.
you know, so...
Yeah.
I went and got the basics, scissors, threads, needles,
uh-huh,
and everything.
Uh-huh.
And I just taught myself how to sew for 3 months.
Wow. Wow. You put in the work in the craft, right?
Right. I stayed in the attic. I taught myself how to sew. And I knew that time was running out because I'm the type of person who can't live with people.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, I got to bust another move.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I said, I can't really bust it here because Atlanta is like cliquish. And if
yeah.
you're not in the clique, then mm-hmm. you're just not with it. So
correct.
You gotta
you're
find
an outsider,
your way.
Basically.
Pretty
yeah.
much.
Yeah.
And so I said, I can't see music happening because where I'm at, I'm not in love with music no
mm-hmm,
more.
Mm-hmm.
And I was trying to record. I mean, we was going to studios. I recorded a couple of songs, but I just wasn't feeling it.
So you wasn't passionate about it mm-mm. anymore.
I had lost. The thrill was gone.
Okay.
So I drove back to L.A.
Mm-hmm.
And I just started moving in the same circles because, hey, I'm still Big Chan.
Everybody
don't
Big
know,
Chan, right?
You know what's
Chan,
really going
right.
on.
Exactly.
And, you know, I wasn't looking like my struggle. So I
yeah,
was able to
right.
still
a lot
move
of,
and
right,
be like,
exactly.
hey.
What we say before we came on, Amber, faking it till we make it.
Yeah.
I think we're doing a damn good job.
Never going to wear my struggle. Ever.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm
Thank
saying?
God we don't look like what we've been through, right?
Hey, hello, hi.
Yeah, hello, hi. I'm going to stop you right there, and I'm going to jump back on Amber
okay.
here because she's done some, she's been on some reality shows, right? According to Alex, Whoopi Goldberg's daughter.
Yes, on Centric TV.
Yeah, on Centric, okay.
Yeah, it, when did it come? You know, it just passed, but we had 6 episodes, and actually, can you hear me better now?
Okay.
I'll see you waving for Jesus. I'm like, okay, hey, hi. The name of the show is called According to Alex on Centric TV, and it's a family show. It's
okay.
a family-based show, and it's basically about Whoopi Goldberg's daughter, Alex, who's, you know, her kids are pretty much grown, and her just trying to find her own way and
mm-hmm.
try to start a business,
mm-hmm.
you know, with her and her best friend.
Mm-hmm.
And, where I come in at is I'm like her business consultant
mm-hmm.
and you know they're really good friends of mine and
mm-hmm.
I do her hair and her
mm-hmm.
kids' hair
mm-hmm.
So they brought me in to, you know, just kind of help them through the process of what to do with them starting this her nail line.
Okay.
So that's the part where I play.
Yeah.
Now, even though it's not airing anymore, they probably will show reruns of it.
Right.
But it's also on the Centric TV website.
Right.
Their episodes.
And speaking
clips.
Of website. You are a big YouTube sensation, right?
Yeah. I looked today and it was like over 2 million something viewers or whatever. Yeah.
Gee.
And that's a cool little income too, because I get paid off of that.
Absolutely.
Too.
You do. So tell us how you started in that.
Girl. Ooh, Lord. No, I started in 2007.
Girl, you're going to need to give me some tips.
Right. And likewise.
It's been years in the making. I just didn't start it. It started in like 2007.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a bit of a struggle too, because I had bought a house, me and my boyfriend at the time, and then when we had the house, that's when I started kind of doing it,
mm-hmm.
because that's when we had like the Apple desktop, and mm-hmm. I said, you know, and I just kind of, as I was doing hair, I just started working in a salon. This is like kind of after me and Lolita were doing our workshops,
right?
And
Lolita,
that's my mentor.
Right. Yeah.
So I was looking at these videos, and I was like, these kitchen magicians, you know, doing hair out the kitchen.
Right.
I was like, man. They boring. I can do
Me
that.
Too.
But they were like boring, and it was just kind of like no spunk. I was like, oh, this is boring. I could do it. So
right.
that's when I start trying it. And then I took it and start filming in the salon.
Mm-hmm.
And it was kind of like a day in the life escapade, hair escapade.
Yeah, absolutely.
And as time grew, I kind of learned how to monetize it, because then they had that option where you get enough viewers and they pay you to, you know. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
And another thing is that if anybody listening wants to call in and ask any questions to our guests, the call-in number is 323-473-3100. Log on to www.latalklive.com. We're live here in the studio. If you missed the episode, you can find it on Ustream after the show is over. But if you're listening and if you have a question, you want to call in and you want to kind of pick our brains in terms of how everybody got started or how you can get into hair or costuming or even music maybe, I'm sure that you guys can weigh in on that. So 323-473-3100. And so going back to you, Big Chan, you were saying we left off with you and the sewing machine and going to get some fabrics from Walmart. Yeah. And what was the first thing that you made?
They had a lot of kids in that house.
Okay.
So I did some like matching army fatigue sets for the kids.
Okay.
And that's when I knew I was on to something.
Okay.
Now, one of the little girls, she didn't like hers. I was like, okay, cool.
Little
you
Georgia
know.
Girl, right?
Yeah. Okay. Trial and error. We're
okay,
just testing the waters.
Trial and error. That's it.
But long story short, I came back to L.A. and I was making all my own clothes because, you know, I'm 6'1 and a lot of stuff, you know, couldn't fit me. And I was always having to alter or just.
Correct.
Couldn't rock with it.
Mm-hmm.
So I would go to the parties and everything, and people would inquire about the stuff that I was wearing.
Absolutely.
And so one day this stylist was like, we need a seamstress on set.
Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty much how it started.
I
the first
born.
Project
yeah.
that I worked on where I really could show my skills was a show called Noah's Ark. It was on MTV.
I remember that's Patrick Polk.
Patrick Polk.
Yeah, I did my first movie with him. I was a costume designer for Punk.
Ow. So actually, Dwayne Curry hired me for
that. Oh, Dwayne. Okay, yes.
And
yes.
I was the costumer on that.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, when they dressed up in drag, I had the moment to do the whole drag scene. So, you know, my imprint was kind of throughout the whole first season.
Okay.
I worked on the first season.
Okay.
And, you know, like, word of mouth has been my best
friend. It grows rapidly,
friend,
right? Yeah.
Because when there's like a last minute situation or somebody needs XYZ,
they think a chance.
I'm kind of like the go to person,
right? Mm-hmm.
And I can turn around stuff in a quick time,
right?
Like sometimes I only have 24 hours
Correct.
To do it, and sometimes I have to make a whole piece or create something for video XYZ.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's how I was kind of trailblazing in the industry, just behind the scenes,
Right.
And I like it like that.
Great. I mean, you've worked for some A-listers. I mean, CeeLo, you've done costumes for CeeLo, Lady Gaga, you've done costumes.
She said Gaga.
Yes.
Yes, I'm going to flip it like that from now on. Get into that.
Right. Yes. Try that. And then just a lot of greats. You know, I mean, CeeLo was on The Voice. I mean, I've worked on The Voice before, too. And so all the, I mean, that's probably right up your alley in terms of creativity, because he has no limits when it comes to that,
no,
right?
He has no limits. But I got to give a shout out to Kim Berry. She does hair, too.
Okay.
And she was watching my work because I would post up on Facebook. Sometimes I'll make a few things and post them up just to get a reaction and see what people think. Mm-hmm. And she was like, Prince is about to go on American
Prince,
World
that's
War
right.
Tour.
That's
and
right.
And we need some hot stuff.
Beautiful.
So we decide to meet. She came with a bag of his clothes because, you know, I ain't just rolled up on Prince like, okay, what we doing? You know, I guess I had to prove myself.
Right.
And we went downtown. We picked out fabrics.
Beautiful.
And
I made that's quite an accomplishment.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, I was blown back by that because I was a real Prince lover.
Absolutely.
When I was younger, and I'll never forget, my mom took me to Hollywood. You remember the flip t-shirts? I might be telling my age here. But the flip t-shirts, I remember I had one and I had Lady Prince on the front.
Okay.
You couldn't tell me that, you know, that wasn't my guy.
Right, exactly.
But I just said, you know, fast forward till now, I think a lot of things kind of catch up with you. It may not be what you think that it should be like. You know, I'm not gonna be dating Prince, but just because I was infatuated with that man, it just came to pass through the work. You know what I mean? And I was just
that
like
gives me chills. Yeah.
And when I sit back and I just think about a lot of stuff was already being prophesied to me, you know, when I was younger. And it just kind of like caught up to me now. Like, I love the music, don't get me wrong, that's my first passion, but I love fashion too. So God said, okay, this time nobody is going to be able to control what you do.
Right.
This is your gift, and I'm self-taught, so I know that this is a gift.
Yeah.
And it works for me to the point where I could just look at somebody and I don't need to take their measurements.
Correct.
I can make their outfit and it'll fit perfect.
Yeah.
That's why I know this is a gift. And he's like, okay, now you can run this how you want to.
Absolutely. Which is why I'm right here right now, because I love the talk.
And yes.
And this is my platform.
Absolutely.
I talk about what I want to.
And I'm very proud of you.
You've been
paving them same streets.
Pounding them, right? My feet is hurting. I'm telling you, pounding the pavement and still pounding. That's what Amber and I were talking about, single parents, and you do what you have to do, you know, in a non-compromising way for me. You know,
exactly.
I don't knock anybody's hustle, but for me, you know, it was always about staying respectable and just pounding that pavement, you know, and I've been climbing the ladder and getting some great opportunities, but this is the second chapter of my life. You know, I want to retire doing media and talking, and another platform is my own talk show.
It looks good on you.
Thank you very much. I'll take it. So you recently did some costumes for Missy Elliott's latest video, which is just, I love that video and that song.
Man,
yeah.
Listen. That girl is a pioneer.
Oh, she's a pioneer.
That girl is a living legend, and she ain't done with half of what she's going to do.
Correct.
So coming from a female who watched her, because you don't have too many people. Like, yeah, we was in a group. We rapped. We made a statement. That was cool. We were more so entertainers.
Correct.
When you get entertainers in this industry, you only get, like, a chosen few. Like, and Prince is, like, one of our last greats. Like, we don't have James Brown, we don't have Michael Jackson. These are people who were innovators.
Correct.
She is an innovator. You can look at her video and she's not like none of the rest.
None of them.
You know what I'm saying? So what she does is very authentic and special to this music business. And she was a little nervous about her comeback, and I was like, really?
Yeah.
Okay. I would be nervous, but you
No, you got this.
All you gotta do is what you do, baby.
Is do what you do. I mean, the fact that she's so unique. Like, I mean, for me, the I Can't Stand the Rain in the hefty bag kind of a costume.
Yeah.
Like, I'm liking her. You know, she is outside of the box and not like the rest, you know. So congratulations to you on all of that, because those are, like I said, some really innovative names that you've worked for.
Oh.
So, yeah, hand clap.
I take it.
So bouncing back to you, Miss Cobra Red, you have your own hair care line, right?
Yes. It's called Hair Escapades Peppermint Explosion. And I developed it just from you know, it's about solving problems, and that's right. what how you get into business. Mm-hmm. And the problem that I was seeing from clients was dry scalp, mm-hmm. dry hair, and a lot of times shampoos, they have ingredients that the same ingredients as detergents, mm-hmm. which can dry the scalp, you mm-hmm. know, dry, make, you know, have the hair lose luster. So mm-hmm. I just started researching and finding out what's some good natural ingredients that's right. good for the scalp, what helps promote hair growth, mm-hmm. what helps detangle the hair. Mm-hmm. And I started making my products from out of my kitchen, testing it out on my clients. That right. was my focus group.
Right, right, exactly. Exactly. And talk.
As time went on, I said, okay, I need to take this a step further. Let me find a chemist, or let me find a manufacturer who can take my vision and make it really a reality, do mass right. production. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that's what I did. I found a company who specialized in organic products. Mm-hmm. And I told them these are the main ingredients I want in there. And then they added some things where I told them I needed to detangle. I needed, mm-hmm. I wanted to smell like a minty, mm-hmm. fresh, lemony scent.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
we added lemongrass, tea tree, mm-hmm. and
which are good
castor
which
oil good, coconut right. oil, you mm-hmm. know, all these different ingredients and
so you're more
oils.
Into hair care.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Yeah, for
and,
sure.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And even though I do weaves and I even do, you know, chemical services, but the main thing is maintenance. You know, you can have a great hairstyle, but you got to maintain the hair that's on your head.
I'm
yeah.
just not
hair.
Growing my right. edges back.
Me?
Yeah.
Not my, in my top. The part that I leave out with the weave already, because I don't like the full weave. Like, right. you know, it's just not me, you mm-hmm. know. So, anyway, we get into a whole right. different topic.
But I think the main thing is research. It's just yeah. about really doing your research.
Yeah.
That's in any business that you start. And I suggest to even people who are trying to start a business, get into something that you know and that you have a passion for,
right.
you know. Don't invest your money just because somebody may fast talk. I want you to, you can invest in this, you can make this kind of money, you can do that. And it's like, wait a minute, I don't know anything about
right
fabric softener or whatever right. you're trying to sell me.
Right.
Like, I know about hair,
right.
I know about this. Let me take that and take it to another right. level, you know.
And
what I
so
mean?
Is that the advice that you're giving your son to do something that he's passionate about?
Of course.
Yeah,
he does film and music,
right.
and you know, I could, you know, I think that's what's wrong too with a lot of times our parents, we force and we stress, no, we want
well,
you
that's why
to
I was
do
asking.
This and do that, and it's like, take what they know and what know your child
correct
know that they're not gonna be they don't have that lawyer sense. They're mm-hmm. not gonna be a lawyer, they're just
yeah.
not
yeah well because most
they
parents they're like go for the security, you know, and then
right.
they get into the security and they're not happy.
Exactly.
You know? And that's what at first that's what I was doing with my daughter, and then I thought, let me have her do something that she likes and
yeah.
that she's passionate
yeah.
about, so that it won't feel like
and
work to her.
And support her on that.
And support
you know,
her on
yeah.
that, whatever it may be.
Now, this is
you know?
One thing I did insist with my son, was that because I do have knowledge of the business, mm-hmm. The music business, mm-hmm. that's what it is. Mm-hmm. It's yeah, artistic and everything, but know your business. Mm-hmm. But I told him, you know, he would try to go and, you know, make music at other people's studios. They try to charge him $100 an hour. I was like, man, we about to go to the pawn shop. We about to go to the Guitar Center.
Right.
And you're gonna get your own
instrument.
So he
yeah.
controls
what
if he
equipment.
If he wake mm-hmm. up in the middle of the night and feel like creating,
right.
producing some music
exactly.
or filming, he can do
there
that.
There you go.
So
there
that's
you
what
go.
It's about too, is
there
giving helping them and supporting them.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely. I do know what you mean. So Big Chan, what's on tap for you next? What's on tap for you with House of Cinderella?
You know, I be busy with a lot of artists, mm-hmm. and I never have the time to just get my line together. That's been a dream for me. Mm-hmm. I'm coming
clothing line.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm coming with a perfume line. I'm going
beautiful.
To do my clothing line. I just said I have to find a cutoff point where I could just really get that together. I've been doing my research, been doing a lot of reading. I'm also working on my book.
Yeah.
Halfway done with that. Mm-hmm. And you know, I lost my mom last year to cancer, and that was just like my biggest
wow.
fan. So for a long time I was in a depression. You know, I
yeah.
was still working because mm-hmm. I wanted, you know, to keep going. I didn't just want to like wallow in that
right,
and just
right.
be that, you know.
Absolutely.
And I try to be strong for other people, because as of late a lot of my friends been losing their parents.
Mm. Yeah,
you know.
And I just found out on Thanksgiving that my dad has advanced stages of
and it's a rough ride.
And it
especially
is. It is. And my aunt, his sister, got diagnosed with stage 4 cancer about the same time. So,
and it's crazy because it seemed like when they get diagnosed, they're already at level four. And that's where my mom was, you know? And when you find out, like, I know this is off topic, but I just have to say it. When you start dealing with doctors and you're asking questions and they don't care. Yeah. All they care about is that chemo session because you're paying for someone's college tuition.
That's
paying someone's mortgage. Mm-hmm. And they're not caring about the person. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I watched my mom go through that. And it's a helpless situation because there's really nothing you could do with a disease that's mm-hmm. that advanced. Mm-hmm. But I say that to say we just have to take care of our bodies more better. And this food is what's killing us. I just want to throw that out there.
I've been saying that for a long time. What actual foods do you think? It's one food type of food, or is it in meat, or is it in what do you think?
Well,
processed food,
or I think it's processed, and I think it's mainly the meat. I mean, they're slaughtering animals, and we're putting all that energy on a plate, and we're eating. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Are you vegetarian?
I'm working towards
it.
And a lot of times your body can't digest that stuff, so it sits and it festers,
and
you know, it's just like if you leave meat on the counter, it's going mildew and all that stuff. So just imagine what the body has to go through. So if we could just think about it logically like that, then we can make better choices.
Right.
So back on topic, let me pull it back in.
We in that sentimental moment. Let's pull it back in to the creative moment.
But you know, as far as my brand, I'm just really trying to make it grow now. You know, I spend so much time making everybody else look good. So I want to put the Cinderella brand out there and have my girls look good, you know. And I just want, what I don't do, I don't watch TV.
I don't watch much TV either.
You know, I have like little basic channels, but I don't do the cable and all that. And I really I don't follow designers.
Okay.
And everybody think that's crazy, or they feel like, oh, she don't follow me or whatever. But I don't want to get caught up in what you're doing.
Right.
I want to stay in my creative space. So when it's time for me to launch what I'm doing, it's me. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing what so-and-so is doing.
Right.
I'm not doing what this boutique is doing.
Yeah.
I'm
Good
not doing
you,
what
Jen.
XYZ is doing. So I try to stay in my creative space because I know I have something special, and I want to represent that when it's time for me to do my thing. So I think, I always say, you know, every year we'd be like, oh, 14 is my year. Oh, 2015 is my year.
You never know how things
work. I'm not even going to talk about what 2016 going to do. Just don't believe me. Just
watch. That's my favorite thing to say.
That's all I can say. Watch
that's
me
That's my
work.
Favorite thing. Right,
I think when you focus on studying your competition, it takes away from what you need to do, because you need to spend as much time as growing and developing and putting your brand out to the forefront. You
and
know what
studying
I mean?
Your own craft.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, studying your own craft. What's on tap for you next?
Well, now that I got the salon situation.
So, we were talking about that.
Yeah.
So, you came from a studio.
Studio suite, right.
And now you're a storefront.
Yeah, now I have a storefront in Tarzana, California, Ventura.
And what is the name is Hair Escapades?
Yeah, Hair Escapades.
Mm-hmm. Congrats.
HairEscapades.com, you guys.
Right.
You can get
and give us the address in case anybody out there wants to get their hair done. And then we'll get your social media, too.
19537 Ventura Boulevard, Tarzana, California.
Okay, you need to come in and
drag to fab.
That's right. That's your model from drag to fab.
You can follow on Twitter. You can follow me on Instagram. Everything is Hair Escapades. Even my YouTube. Everything is H A I R E S C A P A D E S .com.
Okay.
So from this point, I'm just trying to maintain what I do have. And then eventually I do, because now that I do have that space, more space to do things, I want to do more workshops. And I've been writing on the book as well, What They Didn't Teach You in Beauty School.
Okay.
So it's basically the beauty business. And because, you know, when you go to school, being if it's esthetician, makeup, or hair, they teach you just enough to get that paperwork, to get your license. Mm-hmm. They really don't break down and tell you, hey, this is how you
not the business 101.
Yeah.
Right. Exactly.
So how you can be an entrepreneur and have products.
And what to look forward to, what do's and don'ts. And the majority, I mean, you know, I don't have a degree, my MBA and all that type of stuff. I learned everything through experience.
We have street
and
degrees.
From other people. Right. And just seeing what other hair salons, I just studied the formula. I studied the good part and the bad part, what not to do and what to do.
Right.
And just took that and learned from my mistakes, And, you know, that's
and so that's
how
what
it
you
happened.
Can give
a lot
back.
Of trial and error.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Because I get that all the time from, like, my YouTuber. They're always asking me questions, and I can't really answer them all. I don't really have the time to answer emails and stuff. So I said, well, let me just put what they ask me in the book.
Correct.
The ebook.
Right. Yeah, absolutely.
So you can be able to download it.
Absolutely.
That's kind of my thing, too, as far as where I'm going with the book, because I can't say a specific target market because I've been through a lot, so I can't say where the target is going to go. But I do know that my journey should kind of wake people up and inspire them, because all the things that I've been through, they're not proud moments, but they're humbling moments.
Right.
And that's what I needed for my testimony.
And seasoning moments. You needed to go through that seasoning and that conditioning to be who you are and where you
and to
are
appreciate
today.
Where I'm going.
Absolutely.
And my thing is, I want people, because this generation is so blindfolded, it's ridiculous.
So blindfolded.
And it's like everybody want to be a rapper or a housewife.
Well,
I just want them to weigh your options out, because there's something else you got to be passionate about. Besides what you see.
Well, that's the thing. They only know what they see, because reality TV is raising them, and that was the other extension of this platform. Although it's women's empowerment, I also want to motivate and mentor young
girls. And no disrespect to the housewives,
and no
disrespect to the rappers.
No,
but I come from an era, I didn't mean to cut you off, because this just really grinds my grinders.
Yeah.
You know, I come from an era where hip-hop, we had a message.
Yes.
That has been taken away. When
you
had your BDPs, your KRS-1s, your Public Enemies, your Ice Cubes, they really laid the law down.
They did.
The tracks was tight, this, that, and you could call it whatever you want to call it, but there was some consciousness there. This rap now, there is no consciousness.
There definitely
You know what
not.
I'm saying? It's just about a turn up. It's this, it's that. Mm-hmm. And I don't see where this young generation is going.
Well, again, and we all should care, because they are going to be the next ones running this world. So that's what I'm saying, that this platform has a lot of different extensions, you know, in terms of motivating and uplifting. I'm really concerned about our youth, you know, and I can only do what I can, but it's up to everybody else to get involved and do what they can as well.
It takes a village to raise.
It takes a village. Mm-hmm. It takes a village. So and now we're talking about a whole generation of people who are just watching reality TV and kind of copycatting what they see because they don't know any better. And I believe it starts in the home.
It does.
Again, the other thing of it is this generation, these children have a lot of young parents, you know, so they've come up in households where they've just seeing things that are just have no boundaries, you know, no real rules, you know, that kind of a thing. So so it's just kind of like a domino effect. And I just want to inspire young kids to reach their very highest potential that they possibly can. There's so many opportunities out there, so many grants, so many things that they have access to, they just don't tap into.
And that's what I want to wake up. I want to wake up the sleeping giants.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. So where can we find you on social media?
Everything is under my Cinderella brand. My website is www.houseofcinderella. I spell Cinderella C-Y-N-D-A-R-E-L-L-A.com. House of Cinderella on Instagram, Real Cinderella on Twitter, and Ghetto Cinderella on Facebook.
All right, you got Real Ghetto and House,
but it's all Cinderella.
It's all Cinderella. And for me, I'm Cinderella all hot chicks.
Okay.
All so, hot chicks, hot chick style on Instagram. And follow my YouTube. I'm relaunching my brand, Rhonda Ray TV. So that's kind of like the
I gotta
brand.
Get my YouTube popping like here.
Right.
Put you on, gang.
Yeah, and me too.
All you need is a computer, a laptop.
Well, I have that.
Yeah.
That's all you need, honestly. And then, you know, you can, I don't know what type of camera or a phone that you have, but
I use
the
GoPro.
You can,
GoPro.
A lot of people been using it. Or you can even use your iPhone if you have one. My son does a lot of filming, and that's one thing he learned when he did a professional video with another artist is, girl, them white people was using iPhones and putting clip-ons
exactly
to their to get different, you know what I mean, effects.
Exactly what they were
so
doing.
So it's just
different
about
lenses.
The editing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's all about
so
the editing.
So I could definitely put you on game with that. Everything right now is so consumer-friendly, it's ridiculous.
Right.
You can even
is.
Do your own website.
Yeah.
You don't need codes or none of that anymore.
Right.
You have,
I did my
you know
own
man?
Website, and I'm quite pleased
with
it.
And it's beautiful. It's
me.
Nice. It's really, really nice.
Thank you.
I mean, I'm just proud of both of you guys. I mean, we all go way back down. down like four flats.
Sitting on the same right. row in church. Let's right. not forget the Holy Ghost.
Right. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
So we're on our way out. I want to thank you ladies for being on Hot Chicks Live today.
Hey.
Yes,
always be a friend to the show. Invite your friends to tune in. And we'll definitely have to do the... nobody called in.
Oh, okay.
Nobody called in. So we're going to have to
do this.
They
just ear hustling.
Yeah,
but that's fine.
Hustling.
I hope y'all got a lot of bars.
There's a lot of that going on. They see your pictures and don't like them.
Yeah.
But they be lurking. Right.
Yes. Ooh, and when them lurks turn into like.
And you better say that. No, that's. So thank you both for being here today. And congratulations on both your brands and from coming from rap groups. To business
talking
owner.
About the Ustream, so then people.
Oh yeah, Ustream. So if you missed the show, you can find us on Ustream. Just go to www.latalklive.com and look for the link for Hot Chicks Live, and then you can catch this show on Ustream right after the show if you've missed us. So thank you for being with us here tonight, and we'll see you next Thursday, same time, same place.
Ow.
Peace.
Choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.